you are 55 years and your son is 5 years. What an error. Young man, don't waste your generosity. What are you waiting for? You don't need money to marry. You need wisdom to marry.
Talk to me.
I want to talk to somebody
here. Talk to me, sir.
Any young man you are seeing that is saying doesn't have money is a foolish man. They don't marry with money. They marry with wisdom. Is anybody hearing me here?
Yes, sir.
After salvation, home, 25 years, married 24. Are you married at 30 years? How will you be going for your daughter's wedding as a grandmother? Who is presenting this girl as the bride to this man? You now come with stick. 60 years old woman. What an error. Who do you? If I be a man of God, this December they will go home with you. This December, any power that is fighting your wedding ring, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost. Look for a woman and marry. As you finish playing that drum set, look for a woman and marry.
Yes, sir.
As you finish playing that bass guitar, stop taking them to shawarma.
Yes,
stop taking them to.
Yes,
is anybody hearing me here?
Yes.
After today, put your eye open and see. Your home will work again.
Amen.
Shout that amen 7 times.
Amen. Amen.
The wife came. In chapter 3, Satan came. The next chapter. That thing that made that man to leave, he's not a man, it's Satan.
I hear you, sir.
Don't say because of what that happened, you will not marry again. Don't tell me that English. How will I enter private jet if you don't marry again? See me? That last experience. What I went through. No, you went through it. You are through with it.
Yes, sir.
Young woman, if you remain there, you are telling us you are not through with it. You can't fail exam and fail correction. If you fail correction, then you are blind. It's only blind people that fail correction.
Yes, sir. Uh-huh.
One chapter, take it. Next chapter, said Satan came. Satan will always come where you see family.
Very true, sir.
Satan will always appear. The guy is just loving you. Before you see trouble come, it's Satan. Don't join Satan to fight the man.
I hear you, sir.
Don't join Satan. Anywhere Satan sees love, he must come.
Yes, sir.
When you start seeing quarrel, now Satan. Because he has seen love. Like how you are looking.
Talk to me.
Don't like how you are looking at me. I feel like going to Nyanya because the way people are looking at me. Where was the serpent before it came? Why did the serpent not show up?
Waited
for family to.
Yes, sir.
waited for from me. Yes, sir. That man didn't leave, it was Satan. Forgive that man so that a better one will come. Me, this is my heart, I can't love again. The one waiting, they do me, they show me man for that. No, now Satan, he can't behold what will be turned to a home. Well, after today, by the time I'm done with you, your marriage will work.
Amen.
Come on, I said your marriage will work.
Amen.
You can't hear me throughout October.
Yes.
And walk like a useless girl.
Yes.
Stay. Just stay with me and see if I'm a joker.
I'll stay.
And see if after now your husband will talk to you anyhow. After I finish, I will restructure, rebrand. Remove those wires where they touch. Get a real. Yes.
Help me.
The first law I want to share with you is the law of departure in making your marriage work. I think it's in Matthew. For this reason shall a man. I'm already preaching. Leave. Don't say leave.
Leave.
Look at me, child of God. There are many men here. There are many husbands here who have not left their family.
I hear you, sir.
When I mean family, they've not left their father and mother. The first, you must hear me now. The first key in making your marriage to work is the law of departure. For this cause shall a man leave his father's house. There are many men who are still in their father's house. There are many husbands who are still in their father's house. You can't do anything without going to the village. After 3 months, Papa, they go village. What thing they go do for village? Papa, they go village. Every 3 months, you are going to the village. Every 5 months, you are going to the village. That man is still in his father's house.
Help me, sir.
Talk to me, sir. It's either you are going to your father's house or you are calling your father. Anything happening in your marriage, you are calling your mother. You can't have a good marriage. You can't have a good home. For those of you who have the gift of reporting your spouse to your family, you are a bad down iscar.
I hear you.
That iscar means Holy Ghost will help you in October.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I hear you, sir. Stop that keyboard. I'm not a normal person. For this reason, meaning those who leave their father's house have a reason to leave. For this reason, shall a man, boys don't leave. Now man, they leave. If you're a man, deal with your matters alone.
Yes, sir.
There are husbands who must ask their mother for every step they take. Can I say this to you? If your mother sits with you for 1 hour, she will say something she is not supposed to say.
You are talking, sir.
My daughter, make you begin to save money. All this. She doesn't mean bad, but in long talk, make you save money. Make you save. This man of nowadays, if you give, make you hide some. They choke some somewhere. Now, mother, they talk to you so.
True, sir.
Now, mother, they talk to you so. They save some. Who carry you go house?
Hey.
The father will say, don't tolerate this woman. That's why, your mother ruthless my life. That woman, put her where she belongs. Now you go house, go hear something.
True, sir.
You've not left, you are still in the house. For your marriage to work, I have pastors here who are still in Bayelsa. How would they send them something? They go, they look at me like this. They don't know how to pick signal. They are still in their father's house. The worst people to be with are those who you think they are with you and they are in their father's house.
Help me, sir.
They can't handle pressure. Any small small pressure they resign. Any small pressure they talk. Any small pressure they are reporting.
My God.
Mommy, he's sleeping now. Mommy, it was battle last night. Oh. He just came back. I now asked him, why is he now coming back now? Is it wrong to ask him? And he now told me, now they call mommy. You can't handle it. Why did you marry? If you must marry, you must leave.
Yes.
Now
yes.
Hold on. When you leave, you cleave.
Yes.
Don't cleave without a hook.
I hear you.
These guys are not in the season.
I hear you.
You want to cleave and there is no hook. You will fall down.
Yes, sir. Through, sir. Yes, sir.
Before you cleave, make sure you see a hook. Because if you jump like that, you have fallen many times because you felt there was something with that guy. See the way he dumped you. Look at how you landed. See, today your bone never stretched, Rich. You can't even move to the next one because you are still feeling the pain of the last impact.
Help me, sir.
If our family, please sit down, must walk, we must. Departure from our father's house. What are you telling your mother? Any marriage that must work here, this past must cover their secrets.
Yes, sir.
Don't be everything they tell your friends. Those of you that have friends, you tell things about your husband. You are making your husband useless in their eyes. Am I saying anything here tonight?
Yes, sir.
I prayed before I started preaching.
Yes.
What makes a marriage bad is the people. There are no bad marriages. There are only bad people.
I hear you, sir.
In the marriage. Marriage is sweet depending on the cutlery you use to eat it.
I hear you.
People are missing some serious point I am punching here. Marriage is sweet. What are you using to eat? Why are you leaving that man? Why do you want to leave that home? Give me three reasons. Who told you that there is peace everywhere? Who told you that every home is as sweet as you think? People are only making sure that it works. After tonight, your home will work.
Amen.
Come on, I thought I'll get. I said your home will work.
Amen.
Come on, I said your home will work.
Amen.
I think it's Matthew 19:5. Let me show you something that will pray. I won't take your time tonight. So that you see to yourself that by the time you get out of this place, you will notice. Now, for this reason, a man will leave his father's house and mother and be united to his wife. You see that? Not to be united again to your father. You've left him.
Yes, sir.
Go and unite with him.
Yes, sir.
Go and unite with her. You have options. You have friends. That's why it's not working. You have friends. John, can I talk to you? Sam, can I talk to you? You want to talk to somebody? No, talk to. Talk to. Those of you that have a way of reporting your wife to your brother, and your brother who is not married will now be advising your wife, you are a foolish man. Now your brother will now walk up to your wife and say, look at you, he told me everything. You're destroying your family. Those of you men who have a way of saying to your wife, your father did not train you well. Look at me. This will help you. The man did not train the girl to be a wife. He trained the girl to be a daughter. You train her to be a wife. Oh my God. These people want to make it.
Yes! Preach it good.
When we were training Elsie, I wasn't training her to be a wife. I was training her to be my daughter. You didn't want to marry a daughter. I would have given you a daughter. You wanted a wife. Train her to be a wife. I didn't train her to be a wife. It is your duty to turn her from a daughter to a wife. Yes. Come on, someone is hating me here. Stop looking at them and telling them, look at you, bad character. Look at you, you cannot go. Help her.
Yes, sir.
When I married Cindy, she was not this professional. Because I married somebody's daughter. I upgraded daughtership to wifey.
Ah, yes.
I'm helping you now.
Help me, sir.
So next time, you will not insult that woman like that. And say, your father, the father trained the daughter. You were not in the picture. You came from one village in Oshodi to my father. If you are the type that will always tell your brother bad things about your husband, and then your brother will be warming up. The day he will touch you again, if the man leave you, your brother will not marry you.
Yes, sir.
Be wise. Her brothers, they call one Togidu, they call one Bose. Touch me again, my brothers. As he touched you and your brothers touch him, your brother should park inside the house and marry you. Why we don't have respect is because of you. Whatever is going on, shut up. You are speaking to the wrong people. That's why when your husband enters, they can't greet him.
Talk to me, sir.
Because they've heard something.
Yes.
You are a friend. You have told all your friends about the bad character of your lover. You are indirectly bringing yourself down. Is anybody hearing me tonight?
Yes.
After tonight, what is my assignment? To make it work.
Yes, sir.
That's my assignment. Why am I saying all of this? Because I know I'm talking to somebody here.
Yes, sir.
I know I'm talking to someone here tonight. Your marriage will work.
Amen.
I don't like that amen. Your marriage will work.
Amen.
I said your marriage will work.
Yes.
I receive.
Number one now. The first one is what? Law of what?
Departure.
Number two, law of communication. And I'm going to pray because of time. Job 6. I think verse 25. Communication. People are just talking. They're not communicating. Can we get it on the board, please? This is why we don't quote scripture. It takes them years to get this thing. Job 6. If I don't get it, help me get it. A lot of people talk, but not very few are communicating. 1A, there is what they call the right words. The right words. Let me say this to you right now. This will help you. If you know that thing you are saying to that man, He won't forget it in the next 10 years. You will not see it. There are some words a man should never hear from your mouth. He may forgive you there. He will live with it. In marriage, there are ways to talk to your spouse. One of the biggest troubles in marriage is communication. Your words are full of wrong words, wrong. And the problem about wrong words is the tune. Some women are not moved by the words, they are moved by the tune. You see some men, they will look at the woman and say, "You, I will kill you with my bare hands. I will bury you here." To you, you just spoke. But to the woman, from that day henceforth, you are no more a husband, you are a murderer. You see panic. She go and get spare key in every door. She waits for you to sleep first before she sleep. Because you have said to her, you will use your hand to kill her. What kind of man will talk to a woman like that? You are a hunchback, you're not a husband. Why will you look at a woman and say, "I will kill you"? Have you seen women? When women are, if a woman is angry, if a woman is angry like some of you, you will tell the man, "This, you think these children are your children? They are not your children." Is that how to joke with a man? And to you, it was anger. The man will begin to say, "All the children, you think they are your children? They are not your children." Oh, you don't know it's happening. Look at yourself and your anger when you are angry. This you say, because we don't record it. If a man bring the text message you have sent to him and come and show you, you'll be ashamed of yourself. That's why you've lost him. No matter how you beg, the man cannot come back to you. He still have the record of your tune. Your tune. Even though the man comes back to you, he's just faking it. The tune is there. When you were angry, we don't know if you were angry. It's the tune we record. Your anger, you should have dealt with it a long time. Do I make this thing work? Work on your words. Work on the tune. You're angry. Just come on. Is the food? Is there food in the house? The way you will say it. So there's no food in this house. What is it? It's not your slave. If you must make it work, the right words. As you're angry, okay, so is it. Let it be like that. I know I can't be anything better. Choice of words. And the man is just in the corner smiling. Look at this one. Thank God we've not passed this level. Little anger, you will write 60 pages. Of first degree, second degree, third degree, fourth degree. Reason why you go to school. You will write the man's life. You will explain. You are so good in writing quarrel speech. Yet you didn't leave school with first class. You've never encouraged a man with a write-up before. Have you ever said, "You are the best thing that has happened to me"? You are this in this. You are this. But when it comes to investigating terrible things, you are a graduate. Let me just tell you my mind. Let me just tell you my mind. You think I'm a fool? You think I don't know what I have been seeing? Because I am enduring it. All those things, the man record it. When he wants to help you, the thing will play. You think I'm a fool? The man will turn back. The man misses you. He wants to come and see you. He will say, look, you think I am a leftover? The man will turn back. Right words. Manage your tone. Because men don't forget it. We don't forget it. Ask some men here, they will tell you what I'm saying. All your insults, they still have it in their hearts. Are you a man? Are you a man? Eh? You are asking if he's a man. Because you are angry. Tame your tongue before it destroys you. Tame your tongue before you lose a helper. They are not everywhere. Tame your tongue before you lose the man God has sent to stand with you. They are not everywhere. Have you gotten the same satisfaction elsewhere? No. Have you seen that joy, that MBS again? No. You have met great men, but not that one. That one was specific sent to help you. Yes. Not everywhere. Don't say if one go, another one go. Come, who go? Come, look like who go. It's not like that. We are all guilty of this. How to make the marriage work. Right words. It's called communication. None of you talk to your wife. You've never communicated. Am I blessing anybody right now?
Yes, sir.
And something will be moving your body. You've not right enough. Keep writing. Keep writing. Keep dying. Keep dying. That thing is telling you right. It's telling you to die. That your end has come. You don't know. You know, right? Try to say it's not enough again. You will start again. The man will say it's okay. You will continue again. As the man reply you will start writing. It's your father's demon following you. The man just off phone for peace. As he on the phone again, you know he has woken up. You will start again. No man can cope with that. Is anybody hearing what I'm saying tonight?
Yes, sir.
How do I make it work? If you learn this truth, it will work for you. After salvation, the next thing we must protect is our home. It's our home. What the devil is after is not your righteousness again. It's to make sure he remove your wife. Remove you so that nobody raises your children. If you don't fear anything, fear your children. Stay in the marriage. Because when your children start growing up without a father figure, stop using pride to deal with a man. Show your man your ambition, does not see it. So, you know, I'm a career woman. There's no career woman in marriage. There is a man in marriage, no career woman. I will enter the last point. I close now. Some genetics. That's why I'm going to close now. We've all made these mistakes. When God wants to help you, he gives a season and a time to open you up to another revelation. Not everybody likes such teaching because you cannot help them until they learn by experience. A summit like this that all the youth will sit, some will deliberately not come because they don't want to hear what will help them, because they want to keep living their fake life. Of food we eat now, it may be difficult for a girl to enjoy menopause to 40 years because of the kind of food. Women are ending now 37, 38. Menopause steps in 40, 45. Some don't even see their blood again at 26. And something tells you, you are still a fine girl. People are still coming. The beautiful ones are not yet born. They are 17 years, they are 16 years. Let's make it work. Let's make it work. I'm dealing with marriage right now. And I know somebody's hearing something tonight.
Yes, sir.
All my sons from now, I'll start asking you, where is she? From tomorrow's service. You don't marry because of money. You marry because you have wisdom. Why are you keeping the girl waiting? What are you waiting for? If you don't have good ring, go and buy Kanta. Put the rubber and put on the girl's hand. Will you marry me? Any man who says waiting for money to marry you, he's sent to destroy your life. It is the wise that build, not those that have money. You can have money and be foolish. When I wanted to get married to my wife, the money I had was 3 million. Is that, baby, how much? Because she was my accountant then. No, you are marrying your accountant. A serious matter. Huh? You said it was 4,000. Mine was 4 million. His own, 4,000. Mine was about 4 million. Then. And I said to myself, nobody will support me in my marriage. I won't take a dime from anybody. I didn't take one naira from any human being for my marriage. Are you hearing me? I know what I wanted. There are people, I won't deal with that on Wednesday. A lot of people wish to be married, while others wish that they are not married. I'm going to sit in two classes on Wednesday and talk to them. Sir, if you fail in marriage, we fail in business. If you can't manage your home, that's how you can't manage your businesses now. I can say this to you categorically. The woman who is not married is not enjoying her life. No matter the money she has. One thing you will notice, they don't smile. Small thing gets them angry because they're not married. Just, you will ask her, why is she angry? Nothing, no. She's her mate has passed her. They are easily angered. Pressure speaks easily. That's why you are hearing me.
Yes.
Because after now,
yes,
marriage will be every Saturday in this house.
Amen.
Amen.
Every Saturday. Every Saturday. When you not meet people like that, 36, 38 up, don't insult them. If they open their mouths, because they know that their time is not on their side. Don't offend a lady who is waiting for a husband. They can be dangerous. If they work in that office is on fire. The day the way they will shout in that office, is it because they untap you're angry? It's not because of tap. Every reaction is out. But have you asked yourself, why am I not married? Are there no men everywhere? That is why you are here. To make it work.
Yes, sir.
I said the first thing, the law of departure. You must leave your father's house and unite with someone and tolerate with that person and endure with that person. Endure. And be patient with the man. Then it works. Then number two, have time to talk. Don't be doing things by yourself without involving her. Without involving her. Oh, I just bought a car. You didn't tell her. I just bought a land. You didn't tell her. I am building. You didn't tell her. What kind of life is that? In every plan, the woman must be in it. As I close, lift your right hand up. Say in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
My home is blessed.
My home is blessed.
Come on, say my home is blessed.
My home is blessed.
I can hear you say my home is blessed.
My home is blessed.
Shout again, say my home is blessed.
My home is blessed.
Enough time. Genetic makeup, as I'm going to end. That's the last thing I'm going to deal with tonight. Look, all the women, look at me. Look at me. Look at my ugly face. No man loves a confrontational woman. Let me say my mind. Keep your mind. It has ruined relationship. No man loves a naggy woman. No man loves a suspicious woman. Let me say this to you. Can I still talk to you here?
Yes, sir.
It's not everything you react about. After today, go and cultivate the spirit of meekness. Go and cultivate it. What is meekness? Strength under control. He got me angry, but I will not react. You have won that man's heart. Watch this. You know, we have iPhone now. Is that okay? Look at everybody. I want to help your marriage.
Help myself.
Because maybe you have used your own hand and killed your own love. You are the one crying. The man is drinking ice cream.
Help my life.
Because men are logical in reasoning. Women are emotionally. You know, iPhone, maybe I know you don't look at your husband's phone, maybe by mistake, somehow, you now saw I miss you as you are passing. I just said, no man love a confront. You lost the man the day you showed him your color. Money cannot buy it back. And the man is waiting for that day. Where in front of his friends or alone, you look at him and you shout at him. The man may forgive you, but daily as I live, often as I preach, all your right up is available in my heart. It's in the heart of the man. I mean, this guy talked to like this. I bring myself low. The man will start regretting some things. Ah, now see, finish. Don't push your husband outside. Don't push your spouse outside. Don't push your lover outside because you saw their weakness. Marriage is a school. We are all growing. Marriage is a coming together of two imperfect people. If you are strengthened here, don't use your strength to call us a prostitute. Just why I miss you. I know a girl, just why I miss you. She took the man's phone. She didn't open it, broke the phone. Maybe you break my phone. Wait, who they miss you? I said, God will catch you. When they check, my younger brother say, Misa, you don't break phone, SS mass. Now your brother say, I miss you. She was not patient to read, to check the number. You just see, I miss you. Now you break phone, 500,000 naira. You know how many things you don't break. You say, me, since I married my husband, my wife, I've never beat her. Your mouth don't beat her tire. Your mouth don't abuse her. It's better you beat me than I know say beat you don't get to English. What? Those things you are saying, it hurt us more than knife. More than knife. More than knife. I'm showing you the pain of men you have confronted. Why do we remain isolated? Because they are the only one God have said to give you joy. You have used your own hand to kill yourself. But God is going to help us as we begin to pray tonight.
Amen.
Because everyone here, we are guilty of what I'm saying, including me. Including me. No man stands. No man wants to be equal with a woman. Nobody wants to hear this again. When a man sees that you are trying to make him feel you are equal, no matter your money, he will walk away from you. Every man with your money wants to take charge, wants to be in control. Don't make a man feel because of what you have acquired, you people are mates. You've lost the man. In every man, there are three things. Take this home, it will help you. In every man is a fool. In every man is a child. In every man is a king. There is a time a man is a fool, understand his mood and fool with him. There is a time a man is a child. Why would you go and talk to a house guy? That's a child experience. Don't call him. That's a child experience. Understand it. There's a time he wants you to treat him as a king. Most celebrities are not married. Because they feel their position, their class will bring men to them. Today they are isolated. Nobody can relate with them. All the Miss World, Miss Nigeria, where are they today? Or show me a girl with character. She's the one flying with all the big men. Every big man does business with girls with character, not fine girls. Look at me now. I am around big men. All the big men don't carry fine girls to be their accountants. All their structures, their establishments, their administrations, they look for a girl where no fine, but it gets sense. Mama, you are not a housewife. You are a partner. Partner. You're not a housewife. Stop wearing wrapper money afternoon, evening. Stop only buying wrapper clothes. You don't have jeans, you don't have top. What's in the world of you? Go and do exercise. Wear your tights. Wear your stool. Be fitted. I will enter that some other time. I want to end here this night. Look at me, child of God. Before marriage, now us go chase you. After marriage, now you go chase us. Proverbs 8:11. It's an experience Bible. Before that thing, now us they call you 400 times, 600 times. After that thing, hey, they call us. We're busy. Your call. We are busy. Can't you see? We are busy. Now me, this man, they hand call for. Yes, now that's all life day. Before you know, now you they call the man. You go pick again. See how life don't change. Before he cannot do a day without you, but see how life change. I take suffer and I they suffer you back. That's why don't ever stress a man that want to marry you. If he say, will you marry me? What are you thinking about? Let me think about what? Give me some time. Let me think. Think, what are you thinking about? Let me just pray about it and think about it. Just give me time. Don't rush me. I'm fragile. Don't rush me. Really? It's okay. As you are thinking, another girl has entered. Don't ever compare yourself with a man. They are your king. Always respect them. What we lack is honor. Woman, honor your wife, your husband. Honor the man in your life. That is your job. Submit to the man in your life. Don't make him feel you have your own say. What you say, even when it's wrong. I said this and I'm going close. This man will always come back from work. He will come back, go out, come back. The wife started complaining. This man doesn't, he must go out. Okay, now what does he go out to do? He say he goes to drink. I'm sorry, he goes to drink and eat pepper soup. So the woman now bought the drink at home. Is that okay? And got enough pepper soup. The man still drank, ate pepper soup, and still went out. The woman became angry. He said, but they said if they go drink and chop pepper soup, I provided these things. Please tell me, why do you still go out? He said, I go out because when we go out, we discuss and talk there. When I come home, you don't talk to me. Don't talk to me. You don't talk to me. Hear me, child of God. Your marriage is going to work after now.
Amen.
If you check why it's not working, I have showed you a few things tonight. Marriage is not an end, it's a means to an end. You can't enter marriage and say, I will not make up again. I will shave my armpit again. I will be using powder before I sleep. I will not bath before I go to bed. So you now sleep by the bed and you are smelling ugbang and smelling onions. All in the name that I don't born 4 children. It's not going anywhere. Shut up. With 7 children, the man will still go out. With all these smartphones, sorry, with all these smart girls, sorry, with all these. Are you not seeing the way all these girls in town are dressing? Don't you see they have a purpose in somebody's husband? And then you that is married, you cannot go and fit up. You are wearing wrapper, blue, green, red. You use knicker and slip, knicker, use baseball knicker. You think the man will come back to you? That was not what he married. He married a 16th. Do more after marriage. Dress better after marriage. Look sexy after marriage. If you were using Shetos, now use roll-on. Improve on your smell. Make sure you smell something before you do business. Kerosene. Smell something before you sleep. Because outside there, he has a secretary whose only uniform is short skirts. Now come, sir, do you want anything? The man did not call out. Remember, today is 1 year. 1 year, 1 year. I saw that text. You said, I couldn't, I enjoyed myself. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. There are things you are holding. Please, this service is a service to let go. That man you think cannot become anything, that man you think is a slave, lay the weight aside. Let it go. Whatever word your spouse have said to you that is still in your heart, sir, let it go. It is painful, but there is a testimony behind it. Raise your hands wherever you are. There are words that has hurt you. Let it go. Stop telling your spouse insulting words. Stop destroying your marriage. Stop destroying your relationship. Stop using words that will bring you down. Shanda Barata. Let it go. Let it go. There are decisions some of us have made because we were hot. Let it go. Don't say I will help the girl again because she did that. She did that out of ignorance. Forgive. Again and accept. There are many men here who will say, I will not love this woman again. I won't help her again. She insults. let it go. If you hear my voice and you can't let go, then I'm not your father. There are women here, you have bottled some things. You have said to yourself, I won't relate with this man again on this level because of what you heard or what he did. Let it go. Let it go. When you both met, nobody was there. Settle your matter together. Don't allow outsiders to tell you how to live your life. Many of you, you started hating the man because of what that girl was telling you about him. Do you know if you can have an eye on the man? There are women in this church, they will make friends with you to tell you things going on there, to spoil your mind about that person. Yes, they are sending the man text every morning. Sweetheart, daddy, how are you doing? Daddy, how are you doing? And yet they have made sure you hate the person. There are demons everywhere. Demons everywhere. You are going to check your heart. Are you hearing me? Check your heart and check. I'm talking to both married men and those in relationships. There are things you have said you will not do again. You are denying yourself, not that person.
I hear you, sir.
Because relationship must be expressed. Whatever is blocking those things, release it here. When they close, send a text and say, I'm sorry. Send a text and tell the person something. Are you sure you're hearing me?
Yes,
it's
sir.
A sign you have recovered. Raise your hands. I'm not going to prophesy. I just came to lead you in some prayers. Whatever is a weight in me, let it go. Father,
Father,
help